very good evening and welcome to the show. This is Talk with Gaetano with myself, Gaetano. Hope you're having a wonderful evening so far. Nonetheless, thank you for keeping it on Urban Television. Today, my guest is one of those people who is, how should we put it, is a watchdog when it comes to certain ills, I like to say, when it comes to government. Somebody who watches over what they do, how they do it, when they do it, how much they spend, and is always willing and able to put people on the spotlight, make sure they do it 100% correctly. Breaking the odds, we're going to be taking a look at a young lady who, well, is part of the Anti-Corruption Coalition of Uganda. That's the executive director, Sissy Kagaba. A very good evening.
Good evening, Gaetano.
Nice to have you on the show.
Me too, thank you.
All right. So you are executive director of the Anti-Corruption Coalition of Uganda. But before we get into that, I want to get a little bit into, you know, who Sissy is. Where she comes from, what she's about, you know, where in Uganda were you born?
You know, those are things you don't start asking a lady when she was born. And
no, I didn't say when, I said where.
Where, okay, okay, that's a good name. What I had was when.
You see, I knew it. I said
okay.
Where.
Okay, no, but you see, you need to pronounce your words.
Okay, where ya?
Where.
No, where ya? Where were you born?
Where was I born? Mm. I was born, okay, the hospital. Hospital is Mulago Hospital.
Mulago Hospital?
Yeah.
Kampala, basically.
No, not Kampala, but I mean, you see, okay. I don't want to go to Kampala, but yes, I was born from Mulago Hospital.
Yeah, but you're from? But you're from?
I'm from Masaka. Okay, no, wait.
Wait, but me too.
No, it isn't. Okay, my parents are in Matuga, but the village is in Masaka. We used to stay in Bukoto.
Are you serious?
Mm-hmm.
See, I'm Kampala, as in Mulago, but Kalungu 9, Masaka.
No, ours is Natita.
Gwe.
I'm from Mula. I think I remember, yeah.
Pleasure, wonderful. Mm-hmm. We come from the same area, pretty much.
Yeah, obviously.
Hey, now when were you born?
Yeah, you see, that's the first thing.
That's not the first thing, it was the second question.
Okay, yeah, but you see, I didn't know because you first talked of where, now, where, now. Just that one, actually, I'm going to plead a certain amendment.
You're not going to tell me when you were born?
No.
But you know what, now, this is 2017.
Obviously, yes, I know it is 2017.
Yeah, this business of, no, I'm going to tell you when I was born. Yeah. So what? Be proud of your age. But wear it as a badge.
Okay, maybe next time I'll come with a badge and I put it here, then that way I think you'll be able to...
See, this is going to be very interesting.
I told you.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So you are basically from the Masaka area.
Yeah.
How about your parents? Tell me a little bit about your parents.
My dad is a medical doctor. He's a pediatrician, though he's retired. And my mom is a housewife.
He's a housewife.
Yes. They stay in Matuga.
In Matuga.
That is Wachiso district.
You come from a big family?
Well, we have five kids. I don't know that is really a big family.
Mm. Yeah. Well, in today's world, I think five is big because you know how things are. Raising a child is very expensive.
No, it depends. I mean, you know, the people actually who have five kids now, five, six, seven, in this
they can manage.
Of course, they can manage. I think it all depends on how you're able to juggle it out. So, and we have UPE schools. People can actually go to UPE schools and they're able to somewhat manage.
By somewhat.
And I mean, at times, what is a bit surprising is that when you go to the villages, people are somehow able to manage.
Yes, but you see, the village is not the same as the city, my friend.
I know.
The city is very expensive.
Then you should go back to the village.
You should go back to the village.
But then, I think people somewhat manage. Yeah, and I come from a family of five, and I'm the eldest.
You're the eldest?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So there's a lot of responsibility on your shoulders, and I think being the eldest.
Obviously, yeah, it's one of the challenges. You need to look out for your siblings. Mm. You need to keep checking on them. Mm. Yeah, and again, your parents look to you. So at times, there's a lot that you have to carry. Mm. But I think at the end of the day, you need also to know that, I mean, you can never do everything.
That's true.
And again, you can never balance everything. You know, there are issues of people thinking you balance family, then this and this. Mm. In the ideal world, at times it becomes difficult. Along the way, one is going to outweigh the other one. Because at times you find that there's a lot on your plate. Mm. There's quite a lot that you need to do. And being a human being, you cannot split yourself into equal parts.
You can only do so much.
Obviously, yeah. But you see, in the type of society that we live in, they expect you to literally almost do each and everything. Mm-hmm. So it becomes difficult for a person to understand your limitations as a human being.
Now, we were talking a bit earlier on, Sissy, about maybe your personality. You were telling me you growing up, you were a bit reserved.
Yeah.
You were a bit of an introvert. And which is very interesting considering the kind of work that you do as a watchdog. You speak out and you talk.
Mm-hmm.
But where did this reservation come from, this introvertness? And when did you sort of break out of that mold?
I used to, and I think at times I'm still shy, which at times people may find rather difficult. But most of the time when I was growing up, I used to be a very shy and reserved person. Now, that at times comes out. I only talk a lot when I get used to people, if I get to know a particular person.
Yeah.
And if the person more or less is at the same wavelength, I think we can talk and talk and talk and talk.
Mm.
But there are times I've been accused of being a snob because I'm going to come and I'll keep quiet. The people that I studied with probably in secondary school, most of them meet me and they ask me that, okay, where, when and how did you change?
Mm.
Because I used to be extremely quiet and very, very reserved. But I think along the way, campus will end up changing or something like that. But I think the real talkative part or the real being confrontation and talking comes out to the nature of the job.
Mm.
Because I never knew that I would actually also speak or talk about particular issues because I didn't really have the confidence in myself. But one of the things that I realized that there are particular talents that a person may have, not until when you are in a particular position that other bit of you will come out.
It will shine through.
Because I never imagined myself that I would talk. I always want to keep at the back.
In the background, sort of work, you know, from behind and sort of manage things, but not at the forefront.
Yeah.
What schools did you go to, Sisi?
I went to Kitante Primary School, then I went to Ndeje, then I went to Makere, then I went to Law Development Center.
Okay.
Yeah.
And obviously, I'm seeing a trend over here from Makere to Law Development Center. You always wanted to be a lawyer? A lawyer?
No, actually, I'd wanted to be a pilot.
You wanted to be a pilot? Sisi, you're lying. You wanted to be a pilot?
No, seriously, I did.
You wanted to be a pilot? Has to talk a lot.
No, I mean, the ladies and gentlemen, you know that whole thing. You know, and change the voice. No, it is fun.
Are you serious?
Mm-hmm.
So what happened?
I think when I finished my A-level, the subjects that came out, I realized, of course, okay, I mean, the particular subjects that you need to do.
Right.
But I think I wasn't really so good at those subjects. And so you find yourself doing something else. But my mom used to tell me that, are you babe? I think you're going to be a liar because you argue a lot. I mean, you know how we keep arguing and stuff.
Did you argue a lot with your parents and your siblings and people that you knew? Were you that person who was always...
Of course, we still argue. I mean, I think it's one of my challenges at times. I never want to lose an argument, but I'm learning that, you know, at times it's not all about winning. Of course, yes, you argue and at times you may have to take a back seat. But I think my personality at times is, you find yourself you need to argue, but not all the time.
Not all the time. Mm-hmm. Have you ever been, because I used to argue a lot when I was growing up, and my parents actually said to me the same thing as you, you're going to be a lawyer because you argue. But there were times, and I don't know how, if it's the same with you, did you ever used to argue even when you knew you were wrong?
I mean, we all argue even now when we know we are wrong. I mean, it is. Yeah.
You're like, I don't care. I'm gonna convince this person that my lie is the truth.
Yes. Yeah, it happened. I mean, it does. I think it's a personality thing.
Yeah.
But again, I think when you're growing up, at times you need to change it. But you see, the times are you're caught up in this web.
Mm.
And okay, this is what I thought is the truth. And then along there, someone comes and gives you particular information. But you're not like in Lugano, talk about Kusemba na Choi. So you go on and on and bring in even other clumsy examples that are not related. But because I don't want to lose the argument, so I'll go on and on.
Yeah.
And on. Yeah, so at times it happens. But I think eventually we need to outgrow some of those things. But at times it is fun, especially when whereby you know that this person is right, but I'm not going to allow that you're right.
Mm.
So I just go on and on and on and on. Yeah. But at times it's very taxing. Yeah? You know, you have to continue arguing and argue and that's a thing people don't know. At times when you argue, actually you lose a lot of energy
that's
when you're
very
talking.
True.
Yeah. And at the end of the day you're extremely exhausted. Yeah.
It takes a lot out of you.
But it does. There's a certain person that is some very common personality.
Mm.
We're meeting I think at the German residence. And this was the first time I was meeting this guy. My goodness, the guy could talk. You know, at times you hear the person on radio, but when you actually meet him, and I actually got tired on his behalf because he spoke. And I said, okay. No. So I realized that actually at times, I mean, talking actually takes a lot of energy. It's one of those that actually can really, really, really drain you. So even when you're going into an argument, you need to be sure that you're going to win it. And you need to be prepared because you're going to need a lot of
energy to do it.
Yes, if you're going to argue through and through.
Sisi, tell me, of course, now, you know, coming out to the Law Development Center, you focused and said, perhaps now, this is going to be my career. To get to where you are now, because you're the executive director of the Anti-Corruption Coalition of Uganda, which does a fantastic job, I must admit. But tell me a little bit about some of the organizations that you have sort of gone through or worked with to get
actually,
to where you
are. Actually, I think I worked for a law firm, and then I joined Uganda Human Rights Commission. And then I joined the Anti-Corruption Coalition Uganda. Mm-hmm. Of course, when I joined Anti-Corruption Coalition Uganda, I joined as an advocacy officer. Mm-hmm. It was when the position came up that I applied. But I still didn't want to apply for the position because there were quite a number of challenges that were attached to it. And I think also because I preferred being in the background, I didn't really feel that I should apply for the position. Actually, I decided to apply on the last day when they're actually closing. Because I had to think about, because I was thinking, you know what, if you're going to apply for this position, then you have to be out there, you have to be able to speak. And I was looking at myself and I'm thinking, you know what, I'm not so much of a good speaker. So I would rather keep at the background. But I think for me, it was the challenges that I saw that come with it, and I just didn't want to take them on.
Did you at any time, Sissy, you at any time think, because I'm a woman, perhaps there are certain things I cannot do or that will restrain me or stop me because I'm a woman?
Actually, no, that never crossed my mind. I think for me, what crossed my mind was my personality, thinking I can't talk, I'm going to be shy.
Okay.
And it was the challenges, but it wasn't because that I was a woman, I felt I couldn't do it. No, that actually didn't cross my mind at all.
Have you ever had to sort of prove yourself because you're a woman?
Of course, you see, there are people, and the thing is, one, on a number of occasions, people look at it and say, oh, so it is actually, we thought it's this big, tall person. Because I think, I don't know, maybe because my voice is a bit deep. Now, for those that will hear my voice on radio, they're going to expect a tall, huge, and what. So when they see, they say, now it is you now. I mean, so, there's that. Of course, the other public is going to view you at times, yes, as a woman. And if you're not really that, because I think at times maybe height also has something to do with it.
You think so?
No, because you see, people tell me, no, is it you? Okay, yeah, is it real? Okay, yeah, I think maybe it's, yeah, the voice. But some person told me, ah, mani, tonyuma kulaba. Because the person thought, it's because when I went for this particular talk show and the person says, no, it cannot be. I said, yeah, actually, I'm the one. Said, you know what, I think the impression that I had of you is something totally different, tall, huge, big, and something like that. Now I'm seeing this type of person, tonyuma kulaba. So obviously, yes, at times people have expectations of the type of person that they think, or even the type of build they think that a person should be if they are going to have or hold particular positions.
How tall are you, Sissy? Because you're talking about size.
I'm not very tall. Okay, I don't know. I've never really.
You never measured yourself?
No, why would I?
Well, how come you've never measured? But Sissy, really?
No, serious. I had issues with mathematics. So now those things of measuring and no. So it is, no.
No, never?
Okay, I did, but I don't remember.
Well, I think during this show, maybe you can stand next to me. We see exactly how tall you are. We're in the building here on Talk with Gaetano with Sissy. Of course, she is Kagawa, and she is the executive director of the Anti-Corruption Coalition of Uganda, a position that is very prominent in Uganda, especially when it comes to corruption. You know how corruption is in Uganda. Very, very serious. When we get back, we'll hopefully find out how tall she is and get to know a little bit more about our guest after the break.